Hi students, welcome to IGC. Okay, so in the first lecture we have seen the type of flow sensors, we have seen the syllabus, we have seen the previous year questions. In the second lecture we have seen the what is the basics of the flow, what are the type of flow, what is the profile of the flow. So we have concluded that there are two type of flow profile. One is your laminar and another is your turbulent. This is because of their profile. One layer is not interacting with the other layer. Here, one layer is interacting with the other layer. So then there were different Reynolds number for this. There were different Reynolds number for this. So this Reynolds number signifies that which forces are more prominent. In laminar flow, which forces are more prominent, whether inertial forces are more prominent or your viscous forces are more prominent, right? So we have studied there are two type of forces, there are viscous or inertial. So here in the also in the same way in the turbulent flow, which forces are more dominant? So based on that, Reynolds number is defined. This is what we have studied in the last two lectures. So let's continue in the third lecture. Here we'll see volumetric and mass flow rate. So in the last lecture we had seen what is flow rate. If you take one particular cross sectional area and we'll see how much fluid is flowing in particular unit of time. So we'll take here. So this is your pipe, and as I told, from the center, if you take radius r, then at center the fluid velocity is maximum free stream. Near to the boundary, it is nearly zero. So this is near your boundary. Okay. So if you want to calculate the volumetric flow rate, so you have to take the annular region. As in the last lecture also, I have told what is annular region. If you take the small annular area, and if you calculate what amount of fluid is flowing in this particular area, then you can easily integrate over the radius, complete radius r. Then you can easily integrate over the radius r. So when you are taking the small region, you are taking one small r, and this is del r, right? So this width you are taking as del r, and from the center the radius is small r and the full radius is capital R. So radius r, thickness del r. So what will be the area? 2 pi r del r. So what is the volume flow rate? Volume flow rate means if you take the velocity and multiply with area, you will see in what is Q equal to A into V. So you have seen this formula, or we are going to derive the same formula, Q equal to AV. That is known as your volumetric flow rate. So if you take the area of element and multiply with the velocity, you will get your volume flow rate through this particular element. This is your annular area. So this is 2 pi r del r into V of r. V of r, this is we are taking as a function of radius. Function of radius. Okay, just a second, let me power on. Okay, so here we are seeing that velocity of the fluid is a function of radius. So here similarly we are seeing that velocity of the fluid is function of the radius. When you are coming to the center, velocity is different. When you are coming to the boundary, velocity is different. So based on the radius, the velocity is varying. So velocity is varies as a function of the radius. So what is the total volume flow rate? So total flow rate is your, you can integrate over the radius r, and you will get Q equal to 2 pi r. 2 pi integration of velocity of the profile as a function of radius and r del r, 0 to r. Okay. Right. So If you integrate, you will get your formula as Q equal to A into V. So total volume flow rate Q is nothing but your integration of del Q. And if you integrate, so here what we have to assume, we have to assume that V of R, this is constant. We have to assume that velocity of the profile is constant, and this is known as mean velocity. So we have to neglect the variation in the velocity over the cross sectional area, and this is known as mean velocity. This is V bar. Okay, so finally your formula is Q equal to A into V. However, I will suggest you to derive by your own one. So Q equal to A into V. Similarly, in the mass flow rate, density, you know, density equal to mass per unit volume. So if you see the mass here, mass equal to density into volume. So in similar way, you can integrate and you will get mass equal to rho into Q. Okay. If you differentiate, and you will get the mass flow rate per unit time, right? M dot equal to P into Q, and Q already you have derived as Q A into V. So from here your continuity equation comes. So here you are taking the two points. One point is here, another point is here, and so here height from the one particular datum line is Z1, and height from another datum line is Z2. So generally, if you assume that both this cross sectional area and this cross sectional area, means pipe is flat and the datum line Z1 and Z2 are same. So if you consider Z1 and Z2 as same, and if you also consider that the fluid is incompressible, so rho1 equal to rho2. When fluid is incompressible, rho1 equal to rho2. So if you put this in the previous formula, if you put this M dot, so M1 dot equal to M2 dot. So rho one Q1 is nothing but your rho two Q2. So you can write Q as A into V. So rho one Q A1 B1. A1 V1 is nothing but your rho2 A2 V2. So if fluid is, when fluid is incompressible, this rho1 and this rho2 will be cancelled, and A1 V1 is nothing but your A2 V2. So this is known as continuity equation. Okay. So thank you.